Hello friends, so we have already seen what a deadlock is. It's the condition which occurs when there is a process which is waiting on a resource which is held by some other process and vice versa. So there are four conditions for deadlock to occur. The first one is hold and wait. This implies, I will try to explain in this manner. Let's say we have a process P1. Then that process, let's say we have some more processes P1, P2 up till Pn, and there must be a process, let's say P2, which is holding a resource, and let's say R1 is held by P2, and it is waiting for some other resources, for example R2, R3, etc., to be acquired. So it has a hold of one resource, but it is waiting on some other resources, and these resources are currently held by some other processes. So let's say Rn is holding, Pn is holding R2, P1 is holding R3, and so on. So this condition, I think you understood this condition. Then we go to the condition of mutual exclusion. So this condition implies that there must be a resource, let's say Rx, which has to be held in a non-shareable mode. That is, it cannot be shared by two processes together. So it cannot be the case that P1 and P2 are holding Rx together. So if P1 is holding Rx, then P2 must wait for P1 to release Rx, and then only it can acquire the Rx. So this is the second condition of deadlock, that is mutual exclusion. Then the third condition is non-preemptive system. So non-preemptive system can mean two things. First is process-wise, that is, a process of higher priority can preempt a process of low priority. But here it is a bit different. Here it is resource-wise, that is, if let's say a process P1 and there is a process P2, and from a scale of 1 to 10, this has a priority of 8, this has a priority of 3, and let's say this is holding the resource R1, and P1 now requires R1 and it is waiting on R1, but it cannot just grab R1 from a process of lower priority. It has to wait till P2 releases R1, so it cannot preempt a process of lower priority and get hold of this resource. So this is the thing. This has to be released by P2 itself, and then only P1 can get hold of it. So I hope this condition is also clear. Then there is a fourth condition which is very important. So this is, we have to find a loop. So basically, let's say we have processes P1, P2, P3 up till Pn. Okay, and P1 is waiting for, let's say, a resource called R1, but that, let's say we denote waiting by R1, but that is held by P2, and P3 is holding R2, which is required by P2. So I will W, so these are waiting on these things, okay. And let's say there is a P, let's say we have four processes. So P1 is waiting for R1. Let's say we represent like this, R1, R2, R3, R4, okay. So P2 is holding R2. And let's say, we can say P2 is, P1 is holding R1, and P2 requires R1. P3 requires R2, P4 requires R3, and again P1 requires R4. So this is a kind of a loop example, because P2 will be unblocked once R1 is released by P1, and similarly P3 will be unblocked once R2 is released by P2, and P4 will be unblocked once R3 is released by P3, but again P1 will be unblocked when P3 P4 releases R4. So none of these can proceed because they will be stuck waiting for the resources which are held by each other. So this kind of resource loop is an example. So these are the four conditions which should hold for a deadlock to occur. I hope this is clear. If you have any doubts, please ask in the comments. Thank you, friends.